Can you spare a copper? Thank you, sir. Bless you.
Further dice. Come on then, my beauties. Away, you scurvy wench. Place a bet, Doctor.
No, thank you. Too glorious a day to lose my money.
He has the talent to be the finest surgeon in England, and all he talks about is the sea.
He knows his own mind, Father. Besides, Mr. Bates has only been dead for a few days. Give him time to decide.
There's nothing to decide. We will all go up to London. Lemuel Gulliver will take over Mr. Bates's medical practice in the city, and that's final.
Wait a minute. You can't decide anything. Gulliver's a grown man.
Mary! Mary!
I've got the most fabulous news. The Antelope sails tomorrow, and who do you think they've appointed the chief surgeon?
Gulliver!
Father, Uncle Jack, how's the liver?
Dying of thirst.
Try this.
Thank you, my boy.
Sit down, lad. We've been discussing what would be best for you now that Mr. Bates has died. And I thought...
I'm not going to London, Father.
But why not?
Well, because I don't want to spend the rest of my life pandering to rich old society women. I want some excitement and some adventure in my life. Ever since I can remember, I've had this dream of riding on top of the rolling sea and sailing around the world.
I don't understand you, lad. You have the most marvelous opportunity to be somebody, a professional man with dignity. And all you can think of is dreams and a rolling sea. Can't you talk some sense into him, Mary?
I used to think I could. I still can about some things, but not about the sea.
Look, all I want to do is to travel, to learn more about life and other people. I mean, that's not a crime, is it? Is it?
No. No, of course not, darling. Well, there's lots to do if you're hoping to join the ship in the morning.
I love you. I love everyone. Let's all have a drink.
What a splendid idea.
I still think you should stay here and take that post.
Leave him alone. He's only got one life.
That's it, Uncle. That's exactly it, Mary.
Oh,
And that's all. Nothing to be scared of.
Oh, don't look like no mountain to me. I think it's a monster.
I don't care what it is. I'm going.
You stay right here, Hecala.
You think maybe it's a whale?
Let me go, Falco, please. I'm scared.
Nonsense. We're on patrol. We must investigate. Right. Follow me.
Oh, I'd still like to know what it is. It's close.
Come on.
That's stupendous. Oh, whatever can it be?
Get on your feet, you silly ass!
Sorry, Falco. I tripped. It was an accident.
I tell you, it's a mountain! Just a mountain that stretches to the sky, stupid!
Oh, no, it's a dragon that breathes fire. We're all gonna die.
You're right, Donnick. We're all going to die! Run! Run for your life!
Sergeant Falco?
Yes, sir?
Get word to the Emperor. Tell him I'm in control. Tonic, get me Subtracto.
Sorry.
Who?
The General.
Yes, what is it?
The General.
Yes, get it out.
The General wants you.
General?
Ah, Subtracto. I've a giant of a problem, and I need your help. That's the monster. Let's have a look. Right, Falco, tie it down.
Right, you men, get lots of twine and wood. Hurry!
You will require 6,250 reels of twine, 4,222 arrows, 3,634 stakes of wood, 2,400 axes, 1,280 hammers, 4,500 nails, and 120 elephants.
Gad! What was that? Don't be frightened! There's nothing to fear! Watch!
He's taken a chance.
Come on, for heaven's sake, move it! Hurry! Archers, get into position! At the ready! Ah! Over me, you idiots! Over me! You can't kill me! That's better. Tie's head on! Quickly! Come along, move it, move it! There! Now just a moment! Now pull it tight, everybody! Tighter, tighter! Now hold it, hold it, hold it right there. Right, you may be in position. Good.
Oh, my head.
Oh. Sergeant Falco?
Yes, what is it?
The Emperor wants us to transport it to Lilliput immediately.
But that's impossible.
If that's what the Emperor wants, then it must be done.
Hey!
Oh!
Little fellow.
Oh, me?
Yes. I want to talk to you.
It speaks.
Come on, come on. Up you come. What's all this fuss about? What are you trying to do to me?
Get you to the Emperor. He wants to see you.
Well, if I could stand up, he could see me from here.
Oh, I doubt if you could do that. You're all tied up. Oh, please don't sneeze. I don't. No, please don't.
I don't.
You'll just start kicking.
I don't think I can stop myself.
Take cover. Save yourselves. Be careful.
I see what you mean.
Oh, my head. I told you not to sneeze.
I make a bargain with you. You bring me some food, and I'll promise not to sneeze again.
Agreed. I'll arrange it. Go to the nearest village, get lots of food, water, ladders, and scaffolding.
I'm absolutely starving. I could eat a horse.
A horse?
And if they're small ones, bring me 20 of them.
Sergeant Fargo!
General, sir. I've sent men off to get food for the giant.
Food? The Emperor has given orders to have it transported immediately.
It said it was hungry, sir.
Get me a ladder.
Yes, sir. Give me a ladder. One ladder coming.
Well, now, and who are you?
I'm the General.
Well, General, why am I tied up like this?
Because you're a giant.
Oh. I see.
I have orders from my emperor to take you to him. I will not hesitate to use force if necessary.
And how do you intend to do that? I mean, with my being a giant and all that.
There are ways to do everything. My orders will be carried out to the last letter.
Then I would rather discuss this matter on a full stomach, if you don't mind.
Very well. You may eat.
Oh, you silly ass! Come on. Up you go, you silly ass! All right, now then, move it along now. Come on, move it. Get those baskets up here. That's right, fill them up. Fill them up. All right, that's it. That's it. Keep it moving, man.
More, please.
More meat and water.
I hope he doesn't start on us next.
Make way for the General.
It is time for your journey.
Do I have to travel in a full stomach?
You forget. I have my duty to perform.
You know, all I have to do is to cough. And you will go flying into the sea.
Do it. That's an order.
I was only kidding you. I have no intention of hurting him.
Do it.
I warned you, you know. Okay, if that's the way you want it.
Subtracto, what would it require to get this thing to Lilliput?
583 carpenters, 200 engineers, 2 brigades of soldiers, 2 battalions of cavalry, 568 horses, 263 elephants, 789 trees, 10,000 yards of twine, 14,000 yards of rope, 85 poles, 72 hooks, 22 wheels, and 1 ton of oil.
We'll be right back.
done, Subtracto. Now, on to Lilliput.
Self-locking devices, 74 steel balls.
Lilliput, the most powerful nation in the world.
Lilliput?
My kingdom.
Oh, it is indeed a great honor, Your Majesty.
Do you have a name, dear boy?
Gulliver, sir.
And where are you from, Gulliver?
From a far-off green land called England, sir.
Never heard of it. What's the food like there?
It's fine, Your Majesty. The crops are plentiful, the meat is succulent, and the ale, I swear, was brewed in heaven.
Sounds very pleasant.
Tis indeed, Your Majesty.
Allow me to present to you the Empress of Lilliput. And my son, Prince Enormo.
How do you do, sir?
I'm happy to meet you, ma'am. And you too, young sir.
You are indeed a fortunate man, Gulliver.
Oh. Why might that be, sir?
Well, if you stand up, you can look down and see my whole kingdom at once.
Yes. Yes, you're quite right, Your Majesty. I would consider it a great honor if you'd allow me to lift you to see it for yourself.
Oh, do you think you should, my dear?
Of course, I should enjoy that very much. I'm pretty heavy, you know.
I think I might just manage it, Your Majesty.
I do weigh an awful lot, I'm afraid, but if you insist. All right, let's try.
Oh, Lord, look at that. Look at those mountains over there. And the river there. Oh, my, I'm flying. It almost takes my breath away. I've never been as high as this. I feel like a bird. It's incredible. Fantastic, phenomenal. I can even see my palace at Mildendo. Now, don't drop me, will you? Now, put me down. Gently, please.
Oh, that was a splendid experience. I will see you're made welcome here. Meanwhile, I have a boring meeting with my government, but that's what it's like when you're an emperor.
I understand, sir. And thank you for your hospitality.
You're welcome, my boy!
What a strange little country this seems to be.
Everyone is as big as me toe. It sounds odd, but I swear I could easily stare at the moon shining brightly below. You could pour every river inside a wee cup, and the water would not reach the brim. It's no wonder that all the fishes are fat. They haven't got room for a swim. I could house all these people inside me shoe, and I still would find room for me sock. If I sang very loud, I could deafen the crowd, and they'd never get over the shock. There are miniature mountains and hillsides galore, where miniature children can play. The peaks that they climb shouldn't take them much time. They're only an eyelash away. There are bees and there's spiders that can't be seen unless you have the eyes of a hawk. If you like the east best or the north, south or west, they're all within 3 minutes' walk. But the Lilliput people live on merrily, and nobody ever complains. The fact that they're small hasn't harmed them at all, but one burning thought still remains. No one here suffers from growing pain.
Ouch!
Run for life!
Ooh, ooh, ooh. He's got us!
Where's he taking us?
Oh my God, he's gonna squeeze us to death!
Oh no, not that! Ah!
And where do you think you're going?
Mr. Giant, no, please! Please don't pick me up, Mr. Giant P! I won't shoot anymore! I won't do it anymore! Here, don't eat me! No, no! I won't taste nice! Really, I'm too thin!
Everyone, return immediately to their homes! This is an order!
Oh, please, please put me down! I'm supposed to be on duty! I haven't got a head for heights! Please, please, Mr. Giant! Oh, do put me... Oh, thank you, sir! Thank you!
I have a little present for you, General.
Yes, I can see
Hello,
that.
Sir.
In fact, I have four little presents for you.
Oh.
Two.
Thank you, Mr. Giant. Oh, it was hot in there.
Three. Four.
You rebels will be executed for this.
Executed? Isn't that a little harsh, General? I mean, they meant me no harm.
They have disobeyed orders. The penalty for that is death. Take up the prison at once! Good day, sir!
Well, what do you suggest we do with him?
I say we should drown him! Burn him!
We must get rid of him at once!
Kill him! Kill him! I say we must kill him!
I say we should drown him!
Hurt him, too!
General, what do you say we should do with him?
I've considered the matter thoroughly, Your Majesty.
I say exterminate him.
We need no foreigners here.
And what does our Minister of the Treasury say?
There is no doubt. He will be a tremendous drain on the economy. His appetite alone could cause a famine.
Oh. Oh, my.
I'm sure Subtracto could elaborate on that point.
Each meal consumed by the giant is equivalent to the meals of 1,724 Lilliputians.
Oh, I do envy him that.
He will require a minimum of 18 sheep per day, 144 loaves of bread, and 400,000 cubic blocks of water. At that rate, our water supply will be depleted in 223 moons.
We must kill him now. He is a monster. If we let him live, he will surely kill us. He will bring plague, death, and destruction to our land. Subtracto, how many poisoned arrows will it take to get rid of him?
20,458.
I say let's do it.
Get rid of him now. Yes, now, now, now.
You have made some rash statements, Admiral Bulgaran. But before I reach my decision, I would like to hear from my diplomatic minister.
I do not agree that this man is a monster, Your Majesty.
You're wrong!
wrong, sir. Absolutely wrong.
I think he could be useful to us one day. He's done us no harm. Besides, I'm of the opinion that he should be allowed to stay. He is a kind man, as the general has already witnessed.
Kind?
He's a traitor. He tried to disrupt our judicial system by turning rebels free. I have ordered their execution.
Now, that is not exactly true, Your Majesty. As they did not hurt him, he did not want to hurt them.
Are you suggesting I'm a liar?
Oh, dear me. Quiet, please, quiet. After hearing all your views, I have decided that the man Gulliver should stay in Lilliput. You will make him welcome. Thank you, my dear elders all.
That if we had to make him a woolen sweater, every sheep in Lilliput would be running around naked.
The Emperor! Make way for the Emperor!
Ah, Gulliver. Allow me to introduce my Minister of Diplomatic Affairs, Mr. Reldresal.
My pleasure.
How do you do, sir?
He will look after your needs. Well, how are you this fine day, dear boy?
I'm exceptionally well. I've been extremely well fed, and as you can see, they have made me this glorious robe.
I'm glad that you approve of our Lilliputian hospitality.
Oh, I do. But one thing rather bothers me, sir.
And what is that?
Well, I don't want to become a burden, but isn't it rather costly to keep me here?
You mean you've had enough of Lilliput?
No. I'm fascinated by Lilliput. There's so much more I have to see and learn.
Yes, in due course. Mm-hmm. In the meantime, I'll arrange to have your chains removed.
Ah, good. Good. That means I can move about a bit.
Perhaps. But first, you must swear your allegiance to Lilliput.
Right. Just tell me what I have to do.
Repeat after me. I will protect and respect your land.
I will protect and respect your land.
I will share your fears and your dreams.
I will share your fears and I will share your dreams.
Good. Now we must search you.
Is that necessary, sir?
Of course. I must be sure he's not hiding any weapons.
Very well. If you wish.
And what is this, dear boy?
It's a watch. It tells you the time of the day.
Oh, very interesting. And what is that? It looks like a deadly spear-throwing device.
The comb. I use it for combing my hair. And this is a tinderbox to make fire with.
Oh, fantastic.
My snuff box?
Let's have a look. Yes, let's have a closer look. Ah, yes. Achoo!
You're blinding me.
It's a mirror.
Oh, well, and what have you there?
This is called a coin.
I say, careful now. Careful. Look out, my man. Careful. I say, look at that. Spinning like anything. I say. And what is that instrument?
It's called a gun. It can do a lot of damage if not used properly.
I see. Oh, dear me! What a terrible noise!
I do apologize, Your Majesty, but... I mean... You can see how dangerous these things can be.
I am intrigued as to why any nation should want to invent an object of such horror. Are your pockets completely empty?
Yes. Yes, Your Majesty. Completely empty.
Subtracto, how many carriages will be needed to take these objects away?
47, sir.
Good. Get everything to the museum at Mildendo. But take that noisy thing to my arsenal. I must go now. I'm absolutely famished.
Make way for the Emperor!
Hello. What are you three up to today?
Today is a very important day in the life of Lilliputians. It is Carnival Day, the day they choose the new government.
Oh. Do I have a vote?
Oh, no one votes here. All those people out there are competing for high positions.
The one who walks the longest on the tightrope will be the Minister of...
Foreign Affairs. The best juggler will be the treasurer, and so on.
That's ridiculous. Don't brains and qualifications have anything to do with it?
Huh. I can see you know nothing about politics.
One must never mix brains and politics. You will only get into an awful fix. Living like a fox is unorthodox. There is no greater curse than a ballot box. People risk their necks for the letter X, and they'll cut their throats if it means more votes.
If a man can stay on his head all day without blinking or letting his body sway, he can rule our land. Isn't that just grand? And he won't kiss a baby or shake a hand. And he'll only smile when he wants to smile. These are clever tricks only lunatics study politics.
Just to get into the apple-eating contest.
What for?
If he wins, he can be the new Chancellor.
Oh. And now, introducing Gordon, the strongest man in Lilliput, who is competing for the position of Minister of Weights and Measures. He will endeavor to lift no less than 10,000 cubits in weight. He'll never become a minister now.
If
If you've got the skill and an iron will, there's no end to the dreams that you can fulfill. All you need are sticks and a load of bricks, and while juggling them, see some limericks. That's how we select people we elect. That's not politics, it's just intellect.
We had best explain, there's just one campaign. Here no minister speaks, they just entertain. They won't promise to do things they can't do. There's no sinister minister fooling you. But if you suspect we are incorrect and talk fiddlesticks, we ask with respect, what is politics?
You are making a grave mistake. It's bad enough to let the monster remain alive in chains, but to set him free is madness.
My robe, madame.
If it pleases the court, we have all heard Borgalam's views before.
You have indeed.
We have already established that Gulliver is a friend to us.
But what would happen if he should trip over, eh? We should all be crushed. And then what, Mr. Roundersall? I say we should kill him before it's too late.
Not everyone shares your opinion, Admiral. Gulliver could be useful to our people. He could help build cities in days, plow fields in minutes. We have only to ask.
I don't trust him. Once he's freed, we would all be at his mercy.
You're absolutely right, Admiral.
Enough of this bickering. I have decided to set Gulliver free. The war with Blefuscu is coming to a head. Perhaps there, Mr. Gulliver can be of help to us. Ugh, I feel awful.
What's the hurry, little lady? Don't be afraid. I won't hurt you.
Oh, I'm not afraid. It's just that I have a long way to go.
I could give you a lift, if you like.
Yes, please.
Climb onto my hand. Come on, come on. There. And away we go. My, you do look pretty. What's your name?
Rosanna.
That's a lovely name. I bet you set all the men's hearts aflutter here in Lilliput.
Please don't tease. I'm very sad today.
Oh, why are you sad?
I heard that our country is going to war again.
This country at war? I don't believe it.
My fiancé's in the army. He may be killed. I'm on my way to him now. Can you put me down beside the riverbank?
Why, certainly. But tell me what this war is all about.
Oh, I don't know. Something about eggs.
Eggs?
Yes. Isn't there anything you could do to help?
Ah, I wish there were. But it isn't easy to find peace nowadays, like it was long ago.
I don't care what that fat emperor says. He is a fool.
Setting that giant free was insanity, madness, I tell you.
You're right, General. It is up to us to save our country.
It is our duty.
Correct. We will take the law into our own hands. The emperor is weak, so we must be strong. We must kill Gulliver.
I know just the way.
Hello, my friend. And what news this glorious day?
Your chains are to be removed.
Now, come on, come on. Come along, men. Bring the horses. Hurry it up. Come on, we can't take all day. Come on now.
Good.
Right, come on now. Let's hook up the crossbar. Now, come on, get on with it. Come on, get on with it. We can't take all day. That's right. Off we go. Now, come on. Now, watch that corner. Watch it. Careful. Get steady.
Does that mean I can go for a walk?
Yes, but I'll have to tell the people of Lilliput to stay in their homes for safety.
I promise you I'll be extremely careful. Not a single leaf will stir.
Where would you like to go? There are a great many places for you to see.
I see. I'd like to take a closer look at the palace of Mildendo. Is that possible?
I will arrange it.
Thank you.
Citizens of Lilliput, I have called you here to tell you that Gulliver has been set free.
Oh, dear.
No!
We're troubled!
There is no need to be afraid. He is our friend. He is going to travel to Mildendo.
Ah, drat! What was that?
Please go now.
Oh, dear, oh, dear, oh, dear. I think I'll have just a little pick-me-up, landlord. Just a wee one. Cheers.
Ah, it's the giant!
Now, what are you talking about? Now, what's all this talk about giants? I never heard such rubbish in all... Oh, glory be. I never seen anything so huge. Landlord, give us a drop more of that stuff. Oh, dear me. He looks friendly enough. Mind you, you can never tell about giants. Better have a drop more before I face him again. It's a happy day. Oh, the sun is shining in Lilliput and... Oh, hello there, Mr. Giant. What a fine day it is, to be sure. Hey, hey, what's going on? Oh, hey! Clumsy. Oh, what a stupid way of getting your clothes washed.
Hello.
I want to thank you for arranging my walk.
My pleasure.
Well, what brings you here today?
I have come to speak to you in my official capacity as a member of His Imperial Majesty's government.
What's wrong?
War is imminent. Our intelligence tells us that Blefuscu is preparing their finest ships and vessels for a major offensive.
Come on, Red Dressel. What's all this talk about war? I mean, you appear such a peaceful little nation. Why would anyone want to destroy you?
The two great empires of Lilliput and Blefuscu have been at war for many moons. The reason for this conflict, in a word, is eggs.
Eggs? Yes, I did hear something about it.
It's always been the accepted practice of both empires to open their eggs from the larger end. But some moons ago, a member of the royal court cut his finger by using this method. After this accident, the emperor published an edict commanding all his subjects in future to break the smaller end. 11,000 men are known to have died in the last uprising, but they'd rather die than crack the smaller end of the egg. Thousands of these militants fled to Blefuscu, and with the help of some Lilliputian traitors, they managed to form a vast army and navy.
What an amazing story.
The emperor has ordered me to tell you this in the hope that he can enlist your help.
Now, Rel Dressel, I would like to help you, but this is really none of my business.
The emperor also said that I must remind you of your oath of allegiance.
He did he? Well, I'll tell you what I'll do. I will not help you to win the war, but I will help you to stop it.
Make way for the emperor!
I have explained the situation, Your Majesty, and Gulliver has agreed to give us his support.
Ah, yes. Excellent, dear boy. Excellent. Minister, explain to Gulliver our strategy.
This is Blefuscu, our enemy island. Now, intelligence reports suggest that they have 800 ships lying at anchor off the coast here. They are going to sail with the first fair wind, and we must thwart their plans. It will require bold measures on our part.
I think I know just the way.
Nation of Lilliput.
Thank you, Gulliver, for providing us with the most victorious day in our history.
Long live the Emperor. Long live Lilliput.
I have pleasure in bestowing upon you the title of Nardak, the highest honor ever given to man.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
Thank you, Gulliver. You have given us all freedom at last.
It's my pleasure.
She's right! For freedom at last!
Gulliver, Gulliver,
Make way for the Emperor!
Yesterday was your day of triumph, my boy.
Your Majesty, I never got a chance to thank you for this magnificent ring.
Oh, don't give it a thought. Gulliver, I have been thinking. If we attacked Blefuscu now, we would wipe her out once and for all. She has, thanks to you, lost her entire naval strength.
Your Majesty, I've done quite enough already.
I'm afraid I disagree, my boy. It is my policy to exterminate the Big Endian exiles and rebels. While we have the chance, we must crush them like ants.
Now listen to me, Your Majesty. I will not be a party to murder.
You mean you refuse to help me?
I want nothing more to do with your silly war.
You have sworn the oath of allegiance to Lilliput. If you do not uphold this oath, you will be guilty of treason, and the penalty for that is death!
I told you he should have been killed.
To the gallows with him.
I still think it would be a good idea, Your Majesty, to invite a delegation from Blefuscu here. If they were to see Gulliver as our ally, I'm sure it would deter them from ever attacking again.
I disagree. We could overthrow Blefuscu completely in a matter of days. I say, attack!
Yes, attack, 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 attack!
Yes, attack, 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 attack!
Stop shouting! It's not good for my digestion. We will invite heads of their government. If it does not work, we will fight the bloodiest war the world has ever known.
Gulliver, Gulliver, wake up.
I'm not asleep.
You look troubled. Is something wrong?
I want to leave, Rel Dressel.
Why do you say that, Gulliver?
I want to move on.
Then I have good news for you. I have just heard from intelligence that there is a large object on the shore of Blefuscu with the English letters A-N-T-E...
L-O-P-E. The antelope. Why, that must be the longboat. I've got to get to it. But how? I can't run away. There's no telling what damage I might do. And think of all the buildings and the women and children I might step on.
Then listen to me. The president of Blefuscu is arriving tomorrow. You must enlist his sympathy. I know that he'll help you if he can.
I wish to welcome you to Lilliput, the most powerful nation in the world.
It is indeed an honor to visit your part of the world.
I will introduce you to Lilliput's greatest ally. Gulliver, allow me to introduce you to the president of Blefuscu and his government official.
Astonishing.
How do you do, sir? It's a pleasure to meet you.
I've heard of your existence, but to be quite honest with you, when members of my naval force described you, I thought they must have had too much to drink.
Gulliver is the strongest man in the world. The reason I have invited you here is to prove to you that it would be insane to even contemplate war with us. Gulliver, I want you to give these gentlemen some evidence of your limitless strength.
Incredible! What is it?
It, sir, is a man.
I'm the same as all of you, but a trifle bigger.
I would like to invite you to the kingdom of Blefuscu. The king, I'm sure, would make you most welcome.
No, no, that is not possible. There is too much to do here.
Oh, yes. Yes, sir. I'd love to see your fine country. And perhaps with your Majesty's permission, I could go back with them now.
No, I couldn't allow that at the moment.
That is a great pity.
I suggest you go back and tell the king of our indestructible power. Tell him I will be prepared to accept his complete, unconditional surrender. If not, I cannot be held responsible for the devastation that will come to your people.
I will inform our king of your threat. You have an open invitation to visit us anytime.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Gulliver,
No, no, I'm still not happy with this situation. We must be firm and ruthless.
I must admit, Gulliver was a bit too friendly to the president.
I don't trust him. I said it all along. We should kill him.
I did promise him freedom.
But he's guilty of high treason.
Quite right, quite right. Yes, but we shouldn't kill him. Perhaps we should only blind him so he can't leave. Then chain him up again so he can't damage any of our property.
We'll use poison darts, Your Majesty.
Oh, good. Good.
Up we go, up
Gulliver,
we go.
Gulliver! Our Red Dressel. Good news, I hope?
The Emperor would have me executed if he knew I were here. But I must talk with you, urgently.
What is it, my friend?
You must escape at once. The Emperor has ordered that you must have your eyes removed.
My eyes?
Yes. The General and Admiral have persuaded him to punish you for treason. But listen, I have devised a plan to get everyone into Lilliput Square. You can escape then without harming anyone.
You do that, Red Dressel. I'll get to the beach and swim to Blefuscu.
I will do my best.
I have recruited the finest marksman in Lilliput.
I have the most deadly poison. His eyes will start disintegrating with the first arrow.
I have received word this morning from intelligence that when the president of Blefuscu returned home, he told his king of Gulliver's superhuman strength.
Of course he did. What has this got to do with what we're discussing?
Everything, Your Majesty. The king did not believe the president. He wants to see for himself.
Get to the point, Rael Dressel.
The point is that the king is coming here. And if he sees an eyeless giant, neither he nor his people will have much to fear.
Yes. You may be right. When is their king coming?
Tomorrow.
Then we must destroy his eyes just as soon as their king leaves.
I find it hard to believe that their king would not take the word of his president.
Can we afford to take the chance?
No, we will have to wait till their silly little king has gone back.
I also have information that their king will try to persuade Gulliver to visit his country. And I feel that we should hold a public ceremony for Gulliver in Lilliput Square. We should invite the entire populace. If their king should witness a spectacle such as this, there will be no doubt in his mind about the great bond there is between Gulliver and the people of Lilliput.
Yes, yours is a very well thought out plan, Rael Dressel.
I don't like it. I say poison his eyes tonight.
No, I think Rael Dressel's plan is best. Advise every man, woman and child of tomorrow's event. There is no sign of their king yet.
I understand that he left yesterday, so he should be here very soon, Your Majesty.
You better be right, Rael Dressel.
Did you speak to Gulliver, sire?
Yes, I told him not to get here till noon, and then the streets will be emptied and there will be no fear of him trampling on anyone. But I have also placed some men on our beach, just in case he's thinking of betraying us.
There's still no sign of the king. I think it's a trap.
You're right. Rael Dressel has tricked us.
Everyone will be in Lilliput Square, so the monster will escape.
We must stop him.
Your men are the finest marksmen in Lilliput. If only they get one or two arrows in his eyes, he will fall down in agony, and then we can kill him.
I will tell my men when to fire.
Remember his eyes.
It's Gulliver! He's escaping! He's going to the coast! Oh, I've been tricked! Tricked! Traitor! After him! Traitor!
Gulliver! Gulliver, stop!
The Emperor knows. He knows that I've betrayed him. The General and his men are waiting for you on the beaches with poisoned arrows.
Don't worry, my friend. I'll take care of them. You've done much for me, Reldressel. I'd like to take you with me to Blefuscu.
No. I must stay here and face the courts of justice. I have wronged and I must pay. But be very careful, Gulliver. You're not yet free.
You're a good man, Reldressel. I shall not forget you.
Good luck.
Thank you. Good luck to you.
Welcome to Blefuscu. Allow me to introduce you to His Majesty the King.
Your Majesty. I must apologize for being so inappropriately dressed to meet Your Majesty.
I am more concerned with what is in men's hearts.
Now that's a welcome change, sir.
I am pleased you decided to come to our country. I understand the Emperor of Lilliput did not want you to leave. How did you change his mind?
I didn't. I escaped. I wouldn't help him to destroy your country.
I am relieved that you refused. Will you help us?
That's a strange request for a man who claims to be only interested in men's hearts.
Unfortunately, Gulliver, our war must go on.
I will not be a part of any war.
I understand how you feel, Gulliver.
I want to leave.
I think I can help you.
Thank you, sir.
Fools! Imbeciles! That gun could have killed us all. And now, with Gulliver's help, Blefuscu will invade us at any minute.
We should have killed him the day he came here. Then this would never have happened.
Once that idiot of an emperor was right, we must declare war on Blefuscu immediately.
The emperor, right? The time has come, my friend, for us to take over.
Now you're talking.
First, we must eliminate that fat emperor.
But oh,
we have enough poison here to kill 100 men.
Aye.
The Emperor has a great liking for chocolate cake.
He has that.
The next time that fat buffoon takes one mouthful of it, it will be his last.
I like it. I like it.
You do?
Crafty. Clever.
Watch out!
He is guilty of treason.
He has betrayed us.
Well, Reldersall, you've heard the charges laid before you. What do you have to say?
It is true, Your Majesty, that I conspired to allow Gulliver to escape from Lilliput, but...
You see? He admits his guilt.
I don't understand you, Reldresal. You're a trusted minister of the crown. How could you have done such a thing?
In the cause of peace, Your Majesty.
Explain yourself, Reldresal.
I believe Gulliver to be a man of peace, Your Majesty.
Ta!
Did he not save our country from a terrible war?
True, but now he has gone over to Blefuscu, there is no telling what he will do.
He will destroy us!
Wipe us out!
Come now, why should he want to do that? When he was here, he could easily have destroyed our fair city with one sweep of his hand. But he didn't.
Talk, talk! We sit here talking while Blefuscu is preparing for war!
The ministers of Blefuscu have not spoken of war. The only talk of war we have heard of, General, has come from you. And from you, Admiral Ballgullum.
I am a soldier, sir. War is my business.
I say, declare war on Blefuscu before they declare war on us.
Oh, the very thought of war plays havoc with my digestion, which reminds me, I'm absolutely famished. Bring me some chocolate cake.
Why are you so anxious to plunge this peaceful country into war, Admiral? And you, General?
It is our solemn duty to defend this realm.
To the death.
Are you sure that is your only reason?
Are you questioning my patriotism, sir?
What will war do for this country except bring bloodshed, misery, destruction, and famine?
Famine? Perish the thought.
Throughout history, has war ever really proven anything except to make heroes out of the generals and to bring misery to the ordinary people?
I know where my allegiance lies. To Lilliput.
I question your allegiance to Lilliput, General.
How dare you?
I say that what you seek is power. The power to rule Lilliput yourself. And in order to seize power, you both seek to plunge this peaceful nation into a bloody war.
That's treasonable talk!
Ridiculous.
That is a very serious accusation, Reldresal.
I can produce a witness, Your Majesty, who will swear on oath that he was present when these two patriots hatched a plot to assassinate your Imperial Majesty, to declare martial law, and to take over the leadership of this country.
He lies.
Liar! Liar!
Ah, at last, my chocolate cake. And how is this assassination to be carried out, Reldresal?
Poison, Your Majesty. I would not touch that slice of chocolate cake if I were you, sire.
Is this true, General?
Lies. All lies.
Then perhaps, my dear General, you would care to taste a morsel of that delicious chocolate cake.
I have no palate for chocolate cake, Your Majesty.
How about you, Admiral?
I am not very hungry, Your Majesty.
Traitors! Assassins! Murderers! For this you will die. In the most horrible way I can think of. It may take me a little time, but believe me, I shall devise something diabolical.
Murderers!
Villains! Kill them! As for you, Reldresal, I shall make you chief minister of the crown.
Your Majesty is most generous.
Not only have you saved the life of your emperor, but you have saved our beloved country from a terrible and devastating war.
Long live Lilliput! Long live Reldresal!
Long live Lilliput! Long live Reldresal! Long live the Emperor!
Hooray! It's a fine day for sailing, Gulliver.
Your Majesty, I can't begin to thank you for all the food, for helping me to set sail again.
You are welcome. Good luck, Gulliver.
Good luck to you too, Your Majesty.